You can put it like in a little pony, like if you just want to go for a, you know, for like a really simple look, but at least it has like a little wave to it, you know? And there was no damage, no heat. I literally let my hair air dry and then just put it in my braid. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Myra from Low Carb Love. And today we're gonna be going over my hair routine. So I have it in a braid so that I can show you how I try to get like my waves. So I put this, I put it in a braid last night. And let me show you what I used. Oh, I forgot the oil. Okay, 1 minute, it's right there. Okay, so just to go over a little bit about my hair journey. My hair right now is super long. It's growing tremendously within the last, I would say, 2 years. I, at one point, like, burned off my hair. I obviously have super, super dark hair, like, almost black hair. I'm Mexican. My hair is super dark. And I would say it's pretty thick. I just have a lot of hair. So right now, I actually have it thinned out. So my hairdresser, she goes through it and I don't know what it's called, but it's like this little, these scissors, and she just kind of goes through it and like hair just falls out, because if not, I start getting headaches and things like that. So anyway, but it wasn't always like that. At one point, I basically burned off my hair because I was just, it was over processed, things like that. So to get it back to health, this right here was probably one of the things that helped the most, which is coconut oil. So this is just like from Costco, and you can grab which from wherever, like Trader Joe's, anything. And what I do with this is I melt it and I literally drench my hair in it. And like, say I don't have plans that night, I'll put it on at night and I'll leave it the whole night, and I'll put like a towel on my pillow and things like that, so that it just like just sits in there and does its thing. So coconut oil is definitely like one of my number one things for my hair. I also use it as like a serum. So I just grab like a little, like, I don't know, I would say like a quarter teaspoon if you want to measure it, but just a really tiny bit, like a less than a dime, like just a little dab of it, and then just rub it in my hands and like kind of put it through my ends. And it doesn't leave my hair greasy or anything. Of course, if you use a ton of it and you put it into your roots, then yeah, it's gonna get greasy. But like, our ends are usually the driest part of our hair, and so coconut oil helps tremendously, okay? All right, guys, so let's talk about hair health. So what do I do to maintain my hair? First off, I make sure that I have enough protein. So I live a keto lifestyle. You guys know that. I eat low carb keto. I would say that my diet is definitely geared towards more of a protein dense keto diet. And the reason why is because at one point I started losing my hair and I was freaking out. And literally, like in the shower, I started having chunks that were just coming out. And my hair has always been, I've always had really, really long hair. Of course, I was like devastated and I didn't know what to do. At that time, I was still doing a lot of calorie restricting because, of course, I was on a weight loss journey, and I thought I wanted to lose weight. First thing is like, stop eating, right? No, wrong. So you can't do that because your body goes into like survival mode, right? And our hair is not something that we need to survive. So when you're not giving your body the nutrients it needs, boom, like your hair is gonna be the first thing to start to go. It'll start getting like thin, and it'll get brittle, and of course it'll eventually start falling off. And that's what happened to me. So what I did is immediately I stopped restricting calories. The very next day I was like doing research on what were the most protein, nutritious, dense proteins. And so I started, like, at that point, eating steaks and chicken and like even liver. And I really didn't like liver, but honestly, I was willing to eat anything and do anything to first not only get my hair to grow, but I mean, I wanted it to stop falling out. So I started eating eggs, and not that I wasn't already eating them, but I literally stopped having treats like desserts and everything and focused on nutrients. And honestly, it probably took less than a week for my hair to stop falling out. What I did was stop restricting calories. I stopped fasting for extended periods of time, because what I was doing is I was fasting and then I was restricting calories when I would break my fast. That's like the biggest no-no. So anyway, then I started eating more protein. I started taking collagen, and I was taking collagen both with bone broth. So it's having like a cup of bone broth, which has like a natural and organic collagen. And then I was also taking collagen pills at night. So collagen, and then I was taking biotin, which was this little guy here. I just bought this at Costco, and I was taking this once a day, which this one is like 5,000. Yeah, 5,000 milligrams per three capsules. So I was taking these daily. And then I was taking my minerals. So this here has over 70 plus trace minerals. And this is a huge, this is probably one of the things that I contribute my hair health to the most, because a lot of times we are nutrient deficient. We don't have like a balanced diet that's giving our bodies all the nutrients we need. So it's great to actually supplement your body with minerals. So this here has 70 plus trace minerals. I take this every single day, and I do have a discount code for this, which is Low Carb Love. If you guys, you know, don't have a mineral supplement, I would definitely recommend this here. If you guys don't like to take a liquid, these little guys here are both minerals and electrolytes. So I will link these down below so that you guys could see that. And then of course, besides that, I did a coconut oil treatment. Now in terms of heat, so I typically like to air dry my hair. And if I don't do the coconut oil treatment, my hair will literally like frizz up so bad. So I need to use the coconut oil treatment the night before in order to let it air dry. And by air dry, I mean literally just like let it be. It will dry without frizzing up and still have volume. What I found that has helped the most for my hair, so I don't put so much heat yet it still straightens and dries, is this little guy here. So this is the Revlon. It's the Revlon blow dryer brush. I don't know what the name of it, but I'll link it in the description below. This here, I absolutely love it. I think these cost about $50 or so. I bought that. I use it like if I'm going out or something. So maybe, I don't know, two or three times a month. But I really, really like it. And it straightens my hair, I would say, like within 10 to 15 minutes, when it usually takes me over an hour. So I think it's super worth it. In terms of a brush, I like to use this wet brush because I feel like it doesn't break my hair. I like to brush my hair coming out of the shower. And if you don't use like a brush that is meant for wet hair, you're gonna have a ton of like breakage. So I like to use a wet brush. That's the actual name of it, but just use a brush that's compatible with wet hair, okay? Scrunchies, I try to do material that is like, this is silky, or these little guys here. So this here will not leave dents in your hair, which is super important. Like if you're gonna sleep with a pony, you don't wanna do something like this because it will end up creasing, like where you have a dent in your hair. So these do not do that. I don't know if you guys know this, but they're not just for little girls, like, and they actually hold a pony really, really well. So that is what I do for, you know, for that. Shampoos. So this is the one that I just finished up. So I have a little bit of shampoo left, but I finished the conditioner already. This is the Pureology. So this is the Hydrate. So I don't know if you guys can see that there. It's the Pureology. This is the one that I just finished up. And I really liked it. It has kind of like a tingly, minty smell. Every time I put it on, I felt like my scalp tingling. I really like that about it. But if I use this again, it won't have the same effect. Like I have to go through a different product and then I can switch back to this and it will work again. I don't know if that happens to you guys, but I don't know why that happens to me. Like I have to switch off. So since I just ran out of that, let me show you what I bought. I just bought this at TJ Maxx. I thought it was kind of pricey, but I asked everyone on Instagram and they said it was worth it. So I paid $29 for this one. And this is this one, the Argan Oil plus Moringa Oil. So it's the Frizz Free Duo. And I'm barely gonna try it. So I haven't tried it yet, but this one's it here. Let me know if you guys have tried this one and what you guys think. I hope it's worth the 30 bucks because I thought that was kind of pricey for shampoo. So this here, as you can tell, I do have like highlights in my hair. This is pretty, a really strong purple shampoo. I don't think it's the best out there, but it in terms of like clean or healthy, but it definitely does the job. So this is just a regular like Clairol Professional. It's called Shimmer Light Shampoo for Blonde and Silver Hair. This thing right here, if you leave it long enough into your blonde hair, it will literally dye it purple. So it really, really works to get the brassiness out of my hair. But I would love to find a really strong purple shampoo that is also a bit healthier and not so, I don't know. Like, I mean, something like this, I would assume is just not healthy for our hair, but in between, you know, getting it dyed, I feel like it's worth it. So let me know if you guys have a purple shampoo that's absolutely amazing that you like 100% recommend, because honestly, I would love to find, because this is almost done. Like I literally have maybe a tiny bit more use on my bangs, and then that's the end of that one. So if you guys let me know in the comments, I'd appreciate that so that I can check, you know, the most popular one. I will check that out. So thank you for that. And then It's a 10. I love It's a 10 products. I don't know if you guys have ever tried them, but their keratin line is super, super good. This one here is just a Miracle Defrizzing Curl Cream. So I have wavy hair, and this is good just to put it on and like let it air dry. So it basically, I just bought it too, and this one was $12.99. I got it at TJ Maxx as well when I grabbed this. So I hope this one works. It was, you know, it's okay, $12.99. It's not gonna kill me if it doesn't, but hopefully it does its job. So that is what I use for shampoo. This is my little styling cream. The It's a 10 Keratin Leave-In Conditioner. It's a leave-in spray. Obsessed, I love it. I just ran out. So when I went to get my hair done, my hairdresser recommended this one here, which is a leave-in conditioner. I don't know if you guys have ever seen it. It's called Unite, and it's a leave-in conditioner. So this is what I use, and it's working fine. So I will finish this up, but I definitely love It's a 10 products. Like I'm pretty obsessed with them. So It's a 10, we can work together, please. I'd appreciate it. As you can tell, I have super long hair and I do not wash my hair all the time. So I am a huge fan of dry shampoo. This one here is what I've been using, and I have like the different ones. What is this? Like the Beach Babe, and then Clean and Refresh, and Plump. So I haven't seen them do much of anything different besides dry up like any oil from my hair, but I think it's reasonably priced. It's like $5 or $6 for this big 7 ounce thing at Target. So it's what I use. But again, like if I could find an environmentally friendly dry shampoo that's like healthy for our scalp and all of that, I would love it. So also let me know what you guys recommend, like your absolute favorite dry shampoo. I would love to hear your suggestions. So okay guys, so yeah, this is pretty much what I have here is like my hair, I guess like all my hair products. Just always remember, like, you want to try and not add heat to your hair. Don't curl it and straighten it every single day, because that's only going to damage it and leave you with really split ends. I will show you the, I think I have like 3 different ways that I can curl my hair. One of them being the braid, and I'm about to take it off and show you just like a very simple way to like go to sleep so it doesn't, your hair doesn't get all over the place and all knotted, and the next day you just have like a simple wave to your hair. So we're gonna do that now. I will show you, let me know if you guys want to see the other ways that I curl it with a t-shirt. I also curl it with a sock. And then I have these, I have different waves, but I don't know if you guys really want to see that. So let me know if you guys want to see how to do heatless waves so that you don't damage your hair. And I'm more than happy to share that with you. But let me move this out of the way just so that you guys can see this super simple wave. So I literally just put a little bit of coconut oil in my hair last night, in my hands, rubbed it, and then cut, parted my hair in three sections. And then just, I just put the little scrunchie. So sometimes it comes out pretty, sometimes it comes out a little crazy, but I don't know if you can see that. And then it just has like a little wave. I probably look like all bruja status, but it just has like a nice little wave to it. Nothing crazy. And you can put it like in a little pony, like if you just want to go for a, you know, for like a really simple look, but at least it has like a little wave to it, you know? And there was no damage, no heat. I literally let my hair air dry and then just put it in my braid. And that's it, guys. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed my little tips. Let me know what you guys want to see down below. I have the hair masks that I use that are a little different with like avocado and mayo and egg. And I have those, but this was like just my very basic stuff that I use pretty much like on a weekly basis. So make sure that you are following me on Instagram where I share like a glimpse into my everyday life. So if you guys want more of me and my family, then of course follow me on there, which is Low Carb Love. And on here, I hope that you guys are already subscribed and turn your post notifications on so that you don't miss any of my videos. Guys, I love you so much and I will see you on the next video. Mwah.